Ellen HH, Atlanta recap, Jasmine apologizes and sends Rashida latest results. Logan is not the father. Rashida is heartbroken after receiving some DNA test results from Jasmine Washington on the July 3 finale of L&HH, Atlanta. Now, Rashida's convinced Kirk Frost is the father of Jasmine's love child and says it's a wrap. Save the best for last. The finale of Love and Hip Hop, Atlanta was jam-packed full of wild moments, dramatic encounters and shocking reveals. Kirk Frost and Charlene are practically at each other's throats in Jamaica, at the beginning of the highly anticipated July 3 episode titled The End Is Near. Rashida tries to alleviate the tension between her husband of 17 years and mother, especially after he offered to get a divorce. Charlene wants Kirk to admit to his wrongdoings, but that's definitely not going to happen, yet. Kirk shockingly accuses Charlene of trying to destroy their family, and this comment absolutely boils her blood. After a screaming match, she storms off. Rashida finally catches up with her mom Charlene and Kelsey at Pressed in Atlanta. That's the first time I've ever seen him that mad and I don't know why he's mad at me. The most important thing is the DNA. Everybody else asks him that question, Charlene explains. Rashida reveals that Kirk handed her a legal separation agreement, which is a breakdown of money, properties and more in the case they get a divorce. Then, Rashida sees a letter from Jasmine Washington apologizing for the pain, embarrassment and humiliation she's going through. You destroyed my life. I don't FK with you, Rashida says in her confessional. Jasmine also sent DNA test results proving that her ex-boyfriend Logan is not the father, which puts the bullseye on Kirk's back, Rashida says while welling up in tears. To get to the bottom of some issues, Tammy Rivera helps orchestrate a sit-down meeting with Tommy and her mother Samantha. After her tough upbringing, Tommy has a lot of built-up resentment for her, but Sam is tired of constantly paying the price. She gave up everything for her daughter and raised her after giving birth at 17, but she was also in jail for much of Tommy's young life. After they go tit for tat, Waka Flocka's mom Deb scolds Samantha for not listening to Tommy, bringing up how two of her own sons tragically died. Deb explains how memories are all that she has left. Sam breaks down in tears and agrees to try talking to Tommy after cooling down. Luckily, the ladies work out their differences after another heartfelt meeting. Stevie J meets up with Joseline Hernandez to try to work things out, but he's worried after the intense showdown that happened between her and his girls. Stevie's ticked since the Puerto Rican princess disrespected his daughter with no remorse. Joseline wants him to go to New York for an appearance on Wendy Williams and to fire his new artist Estela Quintero. She's been keeping my daughter from me, that's not cool, he says. You didn't answer my call to see my baby. When I call, I want to see her. Joseline threatens Stevie and says she's moving to Miami, but Stevie says he won't let her use Bonnie Bella as a pawn. So much for that romantic proposal. There's no shortage of drama between lovely Mimi and Moriah Lee and Dresser Price. They ladies are getting a pedicure, but things pop off when Moriah asks Mimi if she's friends with Sierra Gates. This is shortly after Moriah's affair with Sierra's husband was revealed. Oh no, why would I be friends with her, Mimi responds with attitude, when I dropped the bomb, oh my bad Moriah, I told Sierra. I don't even know why you told me. It was a hot mess. That's your boss, Moriah. Like you really have to step back and say I'm wrong. I slept with a married man. Things end up getting tense and punches are thrown, before Dresser and Moriah are escorted out of the shop. Stevie finally reveals the hottest new artist for Danger Zone at an event. His daughters are there for the reveal, noting how they'd be livid if he's planning on managing Joseline any further. Stevie shocks everybody when he brings out the Panamanian goddess, especially Savannah who smiles from ear to ear. They're all for him helping out Estelita, especially if it means getting him away from Joseline. Meanwhile, the Puerto Rican princess cancels her appearance with Wendy Williams, since she can't get along with Stevie. It's also revealed that she might not appear on the reunions, because she's been having problems with the production team. Could it be the end of an era? Tune in Monday +8/7C on VH1 for the reunion special of Love and Hip Hop, Atlanta.